In 2010, I spoke with Jean-Pierre Leduc, Hank Jones's manager. We were in the process of setting up an interview when, sadly, this eloquent piano player and composer passed away. I was thrilled to just come across an interview where Hank briefly discusses Lester. Thank you to John Snyder of Artists House Foundation and David Schroeder of the NYU Jazz Department.
Lester, I have to say, was probably the most original individual I have ever met. I mean, everything that he did was completely original. I've never seen anybody or ever heard anybody play like him or dress like him or talk like him. The way he wore his clothes, he always wore a pork pie hat. When I think of his image, that's what I see, the first thing. His style of playing was unique. When I first saw him, he used to hold the tenor saxophone up in this position, the flute position. How he ever did that, I'll never know, because it's a lot heavier than a flute. And just the physical effort of holding it up like that must have been something, you know. It took a lot of effort, but that's where he played. Then later on, he played it down in the original position, you know, the well-known position. But I can never understand why he did that. But his sound was different from anybody else's sound. His style was different. The way he talked was different from anybody else's talk. You know, everything. The way he walked was different. You know, once I saw him at a place called on the Broadway, called not the Three. It was right across the street. It was on 7th Broadway, and at the corner, let's say, where Broadway intersects with 7th Avenue, near there, a little club, downstairs club, and he was in there one night, and he walked in, he was playing a tune. At first he said, "Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to play a tune called A Slow Boat to China, fast." And he stomped up. That's the way he played the tune. But I mean, I had never heard anybody else do that. And this man was a complete individualist, completely different. Great style. In fact, he influenced any number of tennis saxophone players, somewhat the same way that Coleman Hawkins influenced a lot of tenor saxophone players. A lot of people just copied his style, note for note, the way he did. But a very strong influence on the way they played, because it was a viable style. I don't know, it must have been not easy to master, but certainly worth mastering. So they wanted to do that, you know, out of respect for him, and of course, out of respect for what he tried to do in the style that was being accepted by the public, you know. So I think a lot of factors played in there. You know, he had the kind of style that if there was a storm going on, he calmed the storm.